The women's NAIA basketball season is off and running as the Lady Statesmen faced a pair of top 25 teams over the weekend. At the Concordia Cattle Classic, Penn pushed its record to 2-0 after knocking off 18th-ranked Hastings, Nebraska, 52-49. Following that upset, Penn tried to do it again, squaring off with the nation's number one squad, Concordia, Nebraska. This time around, the Lady Statesmen couldn't get their shots to drop and fell 79-56. Staying on the road, things didn't get any easier for the William Penn team as it traveled to Ames Tuesday to meet NCAA Division I Iowa State in an exhibition matchup. CRI's Jason Madison was there courtside as the game unfolded.
Under the bright lights in Hilton Coliseum, the Lady Statesmen got a taste of the big leagues in an exhibition game versus the Cyclones. Since November of 1997, Iowa State has won 27 exhibition contests in a row, including the first time WPU played the Big 12 school since joining the NAIA. However, the visitors looked to snap that winning streak as the first half picked up. With a little over 14 minutes to go, a missed three by Penn was corralled by senior guard Oriel Thomas, then slapped over to senior forward Taylor Reed, who finished the mad scramble with a bucket. Penn down 18-10, but on the come up. Then ISU's lead was cut to 7 when Reed hit this open jumper in transition, 25-18, forcing ISU to call a timeout to slow down Penn's momentum. However, the break didn't faze senior guard Ariel McClellan. With a fake to her right, she creates space and hits nothing but net. The Navy and Gold trail 25-20 with 8:45 on the clock. Then Penn picks up the pace when Thomas gets the steal for the fast break and notices the pressure and stops and hits the J. The Lady Statesmen make it back-to-back scores when sophomore guard Janae Pritchett brings the ball down and hands it off to Katie Galumski for the three, drawing Penn within 3 points with 5 minutes to go. Then off a defensive rebound, Penn has the ball, and Pritchett finds Sam Abens cutting to the basket with a bounce pass, and the junior gets a nice reverse layup to go. Penn down only 1 point, but that was as close as the team would get. Heading into halftime, Penn was down 42-34, but the home team widened the gap in the second half, winning 98-55. In the second stanza, Iowa State hit 71% of its shots to hold a 49-36 edge in field goals. The Cyclones also committed only 4 fouls and did not allow the Lady Statesmen to reach the free throw line the entire game. Oriel Thomas led WPU with 16 points and 7 rebounds, while Sam Abens also reached double figures with 10 points. After the game, Bill Finley, Iowa State's head women's basketball coach, and William Penn alum thought his alma mater gave his current team a good look before they kick off their season this week.
They did some different things. They doubled the ball screens, which we hadn't seen a lot, and they don't have a lot of size, but they were physical. They weren't afraid to get into some contact, and that's the nature of the games we're going to see. They're going to deny ball reversal. We got to make better decisions, quicker decisions. Catch the ball in traffic. It's easy to catch the ball when it's just you and the ball, but when there's other hands in there, you got to secure the ball.
William Penn returns to Oskaloosa Saturday, hosting Morningside in non-conference action at 7 p.m. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Jason Madison.